Hope you find this video useful. Please watch it till the end and don't forget to like it, and please show your support by subscribing to my channel. Let's talk a bit about backup files in AutoCAD. Every time a .dwg file is manually saved, by default, a backup file will be saved in the same location as the .dwg and will have the same name as the drawing but with a .bak extension, such as residence.bak. A backup file is an exact copy of the drawing file prior to the last save. As such, backup files are always one version older than the currently saved drawing. Only one backup file is retained at a time, so newly created backups will always replace older backups of the same name. Data saved in .bak files can be recovered by renaming the .bak extension to .dwg and then opening that file in AutoCAD. Backup files are created only if the system variable isaveBack is set to 1. If AutoCAD crashes or is otherwise abnormally terminated during a session, data saved in .sv file can be recovered by locating the autosave file, renaming the .sv extension to .dwg and then opening the file in AutoCAD. The autosave file will contain all drawing information as of the last time AutoRun ran. When AutoCAD closes normally, .sv files are deleted as any open drawing would be closed or saved normally. The location of autosaved files in the Windows operating system can be determined by going to the Files tab in the Options dialog box and inspecting the autosave file location folder in the hierarchy, or by using the Save File Path variable. In the Mac OS, this can be found under the Application tab in Preferences. Let's see how can we recover a lost file. Suppose my file got deleted accidentally and I even couldn't find it in my recycling bin. It shows in my recent documents, but if I try to open it, it is displaying a message that it cannot find the specified file. Let's get back to the training folder and notice that there are some files with .dwg file extensions and some have .bak extensions. And we are looking for a file with the name residence25ft/50ft.bak. Once we locate it, all we have to do is right click and choose rename. And we just have to change the extension from .bak to .dwg. Click Yes in the next window. And notice the icon of the file now. It is changed to the one that we have for .dwg files. Let's see if it opens or not. So it is working perfectly now. So next time if this happens with you, don't panic. Just follow these simple steps and get your work back. And make it a habit to save your work in between so that you can have a good chance to get back almost all the data that you may lose accidentally at some point while working in AutoCAD. Thanks a lot.